Mercer. Shaw, Rangan, and the Maelstrom form Lucas Gray's Eastern Cell. They are a crack strike team, and stopping them is our client's most pressing concern. Unfortunately, the elusive Maelstrom appears to have vanished into the seedy underbelly of Mumbai, the cradle of his criminal legend, and no one knows his whereabouts or what he currently looks like. So, a bandit queen, a showbiz charlatan, and one certifiable ghost. I shall leave you to prepare.
Welcome to Mumbai, 47. One of the most densely populated cities in the world, home to more than 12 million people. If you wanted to disappear and hide from the world, this vast city is perfect. The maze-like sprawling slums offer secret paths and surprises around every corner. The elusive Maelstrom knows the city like the back of his own hand. Locating him will be a considerable challenge. A place to start could be the slums where his former gang, the Crows, has recently risen from the ashes. Darwood Rangan will be easy to find in his half-finished tower, wrapping up his new film called Mumbai Hero. While Vanu Shah has ensconced herself in the overgrown remains of an old train yard. Your three targets call this labyrinthine part of the city home, so choose your approach carefully.
Mission impossible as usual. Let's get to work, Agent 47.
You know you're boring. Stop being such a whiny little kid.
Ah, he said you're a whiny little kid. Hey, no need, my friend. Thanks. Thanks, my friend. Thank you very much.
My cousin lives in New York, and he went to a show on Broadway. Got a picture of himself and the guy afterwards. That is absolutely cinema.
The American over by the food stand is the famous Broadway actor. What would he be doing in Mumbai?
Maybe he's involved in that movie they're shooting over by the tower.
I suppose that might be. He's wearing a strange outfit.
He is a celebrity after all.
Good food, Pani Purita. Food stand.
Thank you so much.
This is why
I'm
weird.
I
met
Gordon.
That fat guy with a mustache.
Sean.
Not too shabby. Not too bad. Smoking. I don't see.
Oh my God!
The target.
I cannot wait to see that new Rangan movie they're shooting over at the tower. How can you support a man like that?
47, our intel suggests the Maelstrom is hiding somewhere in the city slums. I've marked the headquarters of the Crows on your map.
Go there,
sir. Nicely done.
I wish you would stop talking about the Maelstrom like that, all positive and happy.
What? Why?
Because he's a criminal, a demon. You keep telling all the good stories about him, a freedom fighter, a hero, a brave man, but you know, as well as I do, that those are not the true stories about him.
Not this again.
Wazir Khaile was a thug and a criminal who formed a gang of kids 3 decades ago. They terrorized the city with theft, robbery, and yes, murder. The authorities finally broke them up, but Khaile escaped. He became the Maelstrom after that. A mad pirate of all things, terrorizing the South China Sea for years.
It's that reporter friend of yours that keeps filling your head with these nonsense stories, huh?
She happens to be right. There's even video footage out there of a man, clearly Khaile, bathing in blood of his victims. He's completely insane. And now he's back for who knows what reason. I won't praise him as a god. I pray for us all to be rid of him.
Okay.
Your wish is my command. Say, when I happen to know whereabouts I might find a fellow.
He's spiking my anxiety here.
No, not Nordstrom. Imagine.
It's your brother. Listen, I'm sitting on a gold mine. You know about the Maelstrom, right? That he's back in Mumbai? No, it's not rumors. I saw him. And get this, I took his picture, Bharat. Psh, I laugh in the face of danger. Look, I'm calling you because I got in touch with CNN India this morning. I thought I could sell them the picture. But they didn't want it. Said I was just making things up. But I know it's him. He was with those crows that started walking around the streets with weapons. I need you to get in touch with someone and help me sell the picture. You're a lawyer. You must know all kinds of disagreeable types. But suno, Bharat, someone out there will pay a lot of money for you.
To go back to where you came from.
Somebody has to help me. I can really use some help here.
Can you take back the hotel?
sweating and cold. Maybe it's food poisoning or something. Whew, this is bad.
Hi.
This looks like a very recent picture of the Maelstrom. With this in hand, picking him out in a crowd should be possible.
Whoa.
47? That man there. He resembles the Maelstrom. Try to get close to him for a visual ID. It looks like him, but that's not the Maelstrom.
Have a good one.
Can only be Wazir Kale, the Maelstrom. Identification confirmed.
Heard of personal space?
I would pay a lot of rupees for an autograph of the Maelstrom. He's the greatest hero Mumbai has ever seen.
I don't know.
I think my local Dabawala is a pretty big hero.
Yaar, you're thinking so small. Maelstrom will save the city from the evils that corrupt it. From Daur Rangan and his crazy ideas to Vanya Shah and her cult-like followers. He will crush them and others like them to set the people of the slums free.
Wasn't there a rumor that Daur Rangan and Maelstrom was the same person?
Well, that was kind of easy finding the ghost.
Not surprised.
I'm telling you the truth. Maelstrom left Mumbai because he was recruited by the Red Guard.
How did you
know? Right there.
I suppose you also support the conspiracy theory that India is still a colony.
But that goes without saying.
Listen, think about it. The Queen comes here.
He's real. My brother's employer knows for a fact that he hangs out with some of the worst people in the city. The scum. Vanya Shah is from...
Oh! Someone's been hurt!
Yeah, can't let you through. Sorry, sir. Down here.
Fuck, I lost him. Should anyone see him? He's not there. Guys, he's not there.
I lost sight of the maelstrom.
I love this way of life, don't you?
Greetings, sir. Can I interest you in my fine wares? Cheap, durable cloth in any special...
How much of these?
Ah, my friend, you have chosen well. Now, we have the best prices here. What do you say to 140 rupees per running meter? Does that sound fair? No? Nothing? Ah, I can see you're a man of refined taste and a skilled haggler. My kids will only eat rice tonight, but it's yours for 105 rupees. It's a deal, yes? Wow, those eyes are really burning into me. It's like you're just looking straight into my soul. Okay, final offer now. 90 rupees. 90 rupees per running meter. That's my own cost. I really can't go lower. Still no. Your haggling skills are something else. I'll give you that much. The silence, it's terribly unnerving, to be honest. It's like you're just dead inside. Like there's a vast, empty space where your emotions are normally alive. I can go no lower than 75 minutes. Really, take the offer. Please take the offer. You know what? My grandmother made these with her own hands. There's blood on the loom every night because she works so hard. The fair price is 100 rupees, so that's what I'm charging. That serves you right for just standing there like a corpse. Fine. The story about my grandmother is a lie. You both know it. Silence is killing me. Just have it at what I buy it for. 40 rupees, that's it. Please. It's a fair price. You beat me. Take it. 40 rupees, okay?
It's a deal.
Ah, good, good. Take any of the bundles, please. Just one. Hey, need a new shirt for the office?
Great.
Thank you. Come again.
This guy really wanted like 10 coins for it, talking down to 1 coin. And speak at it. Oh, there he is, the maelstrom. How's the weather?
Did you have any luck?
No. That tailor is impossible.
Oh, shit.
No. That tailor is impossible. I explained to his employee that Miss Shah wants to meet with him, but he claimed that the tailor wasn't available.
So you didn't just go inside and look?
Only the Royal Guard can do stuff like that. I'm sure Miss Shah will send someone with more hands-on experience than me. He's the only tailor in town that can make that damn dress.
That's what happens when you drown all the others.
It appears Vanya Shah is in the market for a dress fit for a queen. She's sent after a local tailor, but for some reason the man refuses to cooperate. A man of your impeccable taste should be able to fill in perfectly for the tailor.
You there, sir, please, one moment. You look like a discerning gentleman. We have the finest wares in here. Best cloth, finest cuts, dresses in all sizes. Come in and have a look. Perhaps something for your wife, yes? Best tailor in Mumbai.
Oh, Vikram, what are you going to do?
Listen, I have to go out for a while. If anyone asks for me, just tell them I'm not here.
Find out what kind of dress a woman like Vanya Shah wants.
You some manners.
Oh, that's lucky. Listen, I need you to help me. It's a bit of an emergency, okay?
What's up, man? Are we in danger?
There's a guy who's disguised as someone else.
Who's the guy? Do we have a description?
Shah wants a cerulean dress, 47. Perhaps you will be able to source a roll of the right fabric at the local cloth market.
Listen, I need your help.
You!
Got nothing here. Quit your goddamn daydreaming. You gotta act on this, man. Someone needs to... Hey, shit's about to get real. I know you're here, man. Come out, before I really lose it. I have to get out of here, and I'd keep my head down if I were you.
I hear you, okay?
How much of these?
Ah, you're back. Ah, my friend, you have chosen well. Now, we have the best prices here. What do you say to 140 rupees per running meter? Does that sound fair?
Fuck no.
No? Nothing? Ah, I can see you're a man of refined taste and a skilled handler. My kids will only eat rice tonight, but it's yours for 105 rupees then. It's a deal, yes? Wow. Those eyes are really burning into me, sir. Like you're just looking straight into my soul. Okay, final offer now. 90 rupees. 90 rupees per running meter. That's my own cost. I really can't go lower.
Come on.
Still
you
no.
You know you could give me this for half a coin.
Something else. I'll give you that much. The silence, it's terribly unnerving, to be honest. It's like you're just dead inside. Like there's a vast, empty space where your emotions would normally reside. I can go no lower than 75 rupees. Really, take the offer. Please take the offer. You know what? My grandmother made these with her own hands. There's blood on the loom every night because she works so hard. The fair
the
price is 100 rupees, so that's what I'm charging. Serves you right for just standing there like a corpse.
Why does it have to be me? Yeah, fair point, I guess. Okay, I'll clean up the mess.
The story about my grandmother is a lie. We both know it. Your silence is killing me. Just have it at what I buy it for. 40 rupees, that's it. Please. It's a fair price. You
fuck me.
Take it. 40 rupees, okay?
It's a deal.
Ah, good, good.
Take any of the bundles, please. Coins, right? Just one will sail on such high bullshit, quality though. Cotton. Sail on high quality cotton twill. Get your bubble. Hey, come on
out. Great. Thank you. Come again.
Silk, cotton, linen. Beautiful.
It's you. Did you bring the cloth from me?
Yes. I have it right here.
About bloody time. Come with me.
Oh, don't be alarmed, by the way. Miss Shah takes security very seriously, so the guards will search
you. Wanna
get
through
here?
Not
to worry.
I need to frisk you first.
What the hell was that?
Oops.
It's you.
This is what I was looking for the entire time.
For Miss Shah?
Because I can't get rid of that. So I have to keep it somewhere safe.
Yes, I have it right here.
About bloody time. Come with me.
Oh, don't be alarmed, by the way. Miss Shah takes security very seriously, so the guards will search you. Not to worry.
Come on. Let's see what you have in your pocket.
Hey! This area is restricted, you idiot. I better not catch you here again, understood? Hold that position. We'll be done in no time.
That's what she goes.
Miss Shah has been dying to meet you. It's not wise to keep her waiting, you know.
I won't disappoint her then.
That is a good idea.
Yeah. Hey.
She's not been happy with the other tailors. A word of warning. Just play along with her eccentricities. She can be rather dangerous.
Thank you. I'll do my best.
What's up?
Good man. Do well and there will be a lot of money in it for you.
I know.
Here we are. Just go through there. The queen is waiting for you in the garden.
It's very warm in the alley where we live. Without water and power, we cannot manage.
I see.
Well,
the whole city
audience
suffers under the water.
That is Vanya Shah, self-appointed queen of the Mumbai slums.
Yes, he is. 2 years now.
And your children are already working elsewhere in the city.
Yes, but
you have nothing to offer me then, Mrs. Banerjee. I'm sorry, but water and power are precious assets here. I barely have enough for my own needs. You will have to make do with what you have.
I understand. Thank you, my queen.
Ah, the elusive dealer. Here at last. Let's have a look at the cloth you've chosen. I want to make sure the color is the right one.
Yes, of course.
Judging
here
by
it is.
The lights and the vibe, I'm guessing this is going to be more suitable.
Ex- Excellent. Finally, some progress here. Come with me. I want you to take my measurements while you're here.
Smart work, 47. Shall we want to have privacy when measuring for the dress? I'll leave the final execution up to you.
You there. Leave us. I want some privacy. Let's start the measuring right away. If you didn't bring a tape, I'm pretty certain one of the other Danes left theirs behind. You can use that.
Relax your back, please, Miss Shar. I'll just measure your arms now, Miss Shar. Turn around, please, Miss Shar. I need to measure shoulder to shoulder.
Confirmed kill on Vanya Shar. Excellent work, 47. No rest for the wicked, however. On to the next one.
Out alive. I was getting ready to dispose of another dead body.
This is my first potential audience with Queen Shar. I've got to say,
what's
this
up?
Place is both beautiful and terrifying.
Huh?
Well, that's half the mission so far. That's what took so long, is that we didn't even know anything about the
mission. It is imperative you notify me as soon as Sardar's barbershop is open again.
It's
an excellent source of information, and I want to make sure he understands who he's working for now. Signal me at once when the shop is open. That is all.
Achai, Badmada. Any idea why the boss wants to know when the barbershop is open again?
Yeah. Saga, the barber, has a side business dealing in information. He basically has every snitch in the slums sharing the news with him. Boss wants him on our side. Barber even came down to the hideout to be shown a picture of the boss so he'd recognize him when meeting him.
Yeah, all the secrecies.
This barber is tangled up in some shady business, 47. But even more interesting, he may have seen a picture of the Maelstrom in the hideout of the street gang known as the Crows. That picture would be very helpful to our cause.
Oh, strange.
You know the boss. He says having a secret identity is key to what he does. But I honestly don't understand what he means. The guy.
Oh, please don't.
By a failed chemical experiment or the actions of the same terrorist. Today. Aether spokesperson assured local Jaybird residents that...
Almost at an hour here, 49 minutes. Let's see what I can get done. It's 11 minutes, but I think I have to cut this up.
Where is he? I need a shave. Why isn't the shop open yet?
This is a barber shop. Wow. Pardon. Next step.
Where's the barber? My job interview is in an hour. I can't go like this.
Bobby! What are you doing? You need to open the shop. There are people waiting outside already.
I can't remember what he looks like. The guy the crows wanted me to provide information to, you know? Their boss. They showed me his picture in their hideout 2 days ago. But I was so stressed out, I thought they were going to kill me or something. I can't remember his face. What if he shows up and I miss him?
Then you should go and explain it to them. They probably still have the picture there.
What if they hurt me? What will happen to you? Or if they decide to burn down the shop like they did with that other guy with the metal recycling, I won't do it.
Bhavik, I told you we would get into trouble with this snitching business. But you had to go and earn some easy money sharing information with the gangs. This is your mess. You fix it.
Uh-oh, we got into some trouble.
Right, 47. We're open for business. We know what the maelstrom looks like and expect him to show up. Patience and shaving cream is what's on the menu now, 47.
Hello, mister?
Is in an hour.
Yes, finally!
Mumbai,
you have no idea how important this shape is. Thank you.
Hello there. Are you interested in cloth wheels? The finest colors and fabric in any.
Maybe later, sir.
Okay, you're busy. I'll come back another time.
Come on in, sir.
Ah, finally. Thank you. Yes. Ah, this is nice. Hey, did you hear about the problem we have with the tailors in Mumbai at the moment?
Can't say that I have.
Well, my sister's husband's nephew works in the laundry district, and he told me that apparently the tailors have gone missing in Mumbai over the past few weeks. Really spooky.
Is that right?
I'm telling you the truth here. A few bodies have been found near the train yard, and one in the harbor. Someone seems to be killing all the tailors. Jeez, I am happy I'm in electronics.
Very interesting. Done.
That is one smooth shave right there. It's always a pleasure to come here. Thank you.
I'm sorry, sir. Not right now.
Forget this. I'll go somewhere else.
Hello, can I get a shave, please?
Shop's open,
hello,
sir.
Me? You have time for a shave?
Wonderful.
Did you hear? The maelstrom is back in Mumbai.
I heard something to that effect. What have you heard?
Oh, not much. Just that he's back to save us from the evil forces that keep us down. I mean, life in the slums isn't that bad, but if he can help get us water and power more regularly, I'm happy.
You think he's here to help?
Sure. Why else would he be here?
That's it. You're done.
Excellent work, Mr. Saga. Your knife skills are simply the best. Thank you very much. Hey, I'm not really comfortable with your proximity right now.
Not right now, sir.
Chalo bhai. Maybe next time then.
Hey, bola na tujhe. I want a shave. Oi nahi.
I'm ready for you.
Jaldi I want a shave. Do well, and I'll make it worth your while. Shane, are you new here?
Yes.
Oh, Shane, you know how this works, right? You pick up on the stories told by your customers and relate them to the boss once he comes in.
Got it. Is he coming by today?
I don't know. He's a bit of a mystery, really. He steps out of the shadows like a ghost. Just be ready for him in case he does show up. Samja?
Oh, I'm always ready. We're done.
Nice shave, Baba. We could use a man with your blade skills in the crows. Kauwo ke beech rahega, khush rahega. I'll see you in a few days.
I'm afraid not, sir. I'm ready for you now, sir.
Yes, I'll be right in. Mr. Sagar, my father sends his regards. Told me you were the best barber in town.
That's nice of him. Who is your father?
Bhavan Vaishnav.
The name rings a bell.
Well, he's a big fan of your work.
I'm pleased. And that's it.
Vava, that is the tightest shave I've ever had. Outstanding service.
Ready for your shave, sir.
Great! My beard's been itching all day. Did you hear the news about Vanya Shah, the slum queen?
What's that? Okay. Good as new.
That was very refreshing. I feel like a new man.
Come on in, sir.
Oh, hero, don't mess this up, okay? Samjha kya mujhe?
What's that?
She recently took over the laundry washing district.
Done.
Oh, good shave, barber.
Shop's open, sir.
Thank you, my friend. All right, I'm ready for my shave. Make it a close one. The tides are changing, my friend. Can you feel it in the air? My bones are creaking with joy at the prospect of what is about to happen.
I don't feel anything, I'm afraid.
You will, friend. You have an important task ahead of you, have you not? I sense that about you.
The infamous Maelstrom is dead. Very well done, 47. Just one target left. Let's bring this one home.